DZONGKHA and welcome to Do You Know Your Child? I'm your host, Choni. It would be crazy to think that people could immediately learn everything the moment you become a parent. As we all are learning and every day is a learning process, you just have to be ready to be an eternal student as a parent. Let's take a look at how our last week's participants are doing.
I hereby commit on the national television that I'll be a coolest father in town.
Do You Know Your Child was an interesting program. It was good, but I felt a little bit shy on that program.
Neither the dangers of the mission nor the treacherous terrain could deter His Majesty from His resolve.
Know Your Child is a platform where some people come there excited, enjoy the show. For me, I would say I did enjoy, but it really challenged the core of my beliefs in parenting, because I had to be on the hot spot. I had to let know our positives and negatives. So it was in some way an opportunity to be introspective and come to terms with how to be a good parent, or how to take care of your kids in the most expected manner.
Parenting is what structures children and teaches them respect, obedience, discipline, and self-love, and provides nurturing support and loving. Because parenting is crucial to a child's development, it is very important to carefully choose a style of parenting that will provide discipline, love, support, and guidance to create a healthy and happy child. Let's see which family we have today.
Hi, my name is Gamma Kinga Dorji. I study in 10 primary school. I'm going to class 6. I like to collect stamps, and my school activity is football. Yeah, I like to introduce my mother and my brother. My father could not make it here because he's out of the station. Here's my mother. Her name is Tshering. Here's my brother. My brother's name is Kilian Kendrup Dorji.
This is Karma's favorite book, The Kingdom of Fantasy. So come, I'll read you a section. There's a chapter on story about the dragons. We were just about to leave when King Firebreath called us back. Wait, I love stories about dragon. If you know one, I'll give you a guide.
Let's welcome our first participant, Tshering, and ask her son later the same 10 questions and tally their answers. Welcome to our show. My first question, as always, is, do you know your child?
I did say that I know him enough to bring him on track if it's going wrong.
Mm-hmm, I see. Okay, so you are a mother of 2 sons.
Yes.
And Karma is the
eldest.
Okay. So tell me, is it difficult being a mother to 2? Are they naughty? Hyperactive?
I think it is difficult to be a mother.
Mm-hmm.
Being a mother of 2 sons, it is challenging.
Mm-hmm.
But every moment, you know, it's when you look back, I cherish that moment.
And, of course.
And yes, it is difficult, but difficult in a very, you know, in a wonderful way.
Mm-hmm, I see. Okay, I hope you wouldn't mind me asking, How old were you when you had your first son? Because you look very young to have two children.
I take that as a compliment, but
do.
I'm not as old, young as you think. Mm-hmm. I had my first child after I graduated in 2001, and then mm-hmm. in 2003, then I was 24. Yes.
So you had your first son when
in
he
25,
was...
yeah.
I 25, okay. So I think that's the average age.
Yes.
That's normal
yes.
age. Okay. All right, so tell me, who else is at home with the kids?
Before it was me, my husband, and then my in-laws were next door. But mm-hmm. now my mother's, after my dad expired, mm-hmm. my mother's move in, and then I have my sister.
I see.
And yes, my husband, my mother and sister, it's a joint
I see, okay.
nuclear family.
Now tell me, normally how the norm... But in this culture, in our culture, it is the norm to be in a big family where you have the grandparents, the uncle and the aunts. But tell me, is it better to just be with your husband and your children, or does it help to have your other family members? Does it help to have your grandmother, your mom, mm-hmm. the children's grandma, or and their aunts and uncles?
You know, for personal reason also, it's trust me, it's... you would want a helping hand, you
okay.
know. You, as a working mother, you know, and the dad's going to office, mm-hmm. you know, and you just can't trust your kids with the babysitter, you know,
yes.
when they're small. And then it's good to have your parents with mm-hmm. you. And then before, as I said, my mom was not living with me.
Mm-hmm.
So then she came in when I had to go out of the country, you
I
know.
See.
For a long time, mm-hmm. me and my husband were away from the country. So then she came in, and suddenly we realized that my kids, you know, both the sons, they're well disciplined, you
oh,
know.
Good.
With the, I think, with the grandparents, you know, they have this strictness and the value,
D, yes.
and then the D,
yeah.
yes. So yes, that's it's good. Forget the value, yes, which is very important,
mm-hmm.
you know. Just a helping hand, you
yes,
know,
of course.
At the surface. It's very good, yeah.
Good to hear that. All right, before we dive into the questions mm-hmm. that I have with me, let me explain to you the rules, all right? I have 10 questions with me. I'll be mm-hmm. asking you the 10 questions, and these are all related to your elder son, Karma.
Yes.
And after that, I'll invite Karma here,
mm-hmm.
and I'll ask the same 10 questions to him, and then later on we'll tally the answers, mm-hmm. and that'll be your score.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right. If all his clothes could only be one color, what color would he choose?
I think he'd like red.
Red. Okay, yeah. All right. When was the last time you and your son visited a park?
You know, as I told you, my father expired, mm-hmm. and then, you know, so no, it's been a long time.
So not even a children's park or...
Yes.
It's been a while.
Yes, it's been a while. But we've been to monasteries, you know, Tshering monasteries.
I
and
see.
Yes, we've been doing others.
Okay, so for question number two, mm-hmm. I will say... It's been a while. That's the answer. All right. Question number three. What is his favorite book?
He's into reading, but he likes stories about dragon. And I think currently he's reading a book, The Kingdom of the Dragon here by Jerino something. Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. So The King and the Dragon?
The
Kingdom of the Dragon.
Yeah.
Okay. Even if he says something like the kingdom of mm-hmm. whatever, as long as you have an idea of the name of the book,
yes,
might
yes.
not be able to
mm-hmm.
fully remember mm-hmm. the name, we'll still give you points, okay? But it has to have either kingdom or dragon in it, okay? Question number four. What is his favorite school activity?
He likes science experiment and
mm-hmm.
he likes games, I think.
Okay, what kind
game
of games?
Classes. He was into basketball and football and taekwondo, but these days I think he plays force. They have this game called you pass around. What is the Foursquare? Yeah, Foursquare or something. But there's this game where they line up and then you know there's. Four kids are there,
yeah.
So you have to throw ball at each other and then
okay.
you have to dodge. So, yeah.
So, do you think his favorite school activity would be, let's name it Foursquare?
Yeah. Or sports, yeah.
Or general
games.
Sports?
Games.
Okay, all right. Question number five. What is his favorite toy? Does he have a favorite toy? I know he's in class six.
He likes robot.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Question number 6. During vacation, where does your son prefer to go?
I think I'll say Bangkok because okay. Bangkok is in our next holiday trip list. Nice. So yeah, I'm sure he'll say Bangkok.
Okay. Has he gone there before?
No. He's okay, excited, right. And because of this, you know, the problem that.
Oh yes. Yeah.
So we have delayed. Yeah.
I see. Do you give him surprises, or has he gotten any big surprises?
Not really, but we. Recently, I planned a surprise for my husband's birthday, and he was totally thrilled. And then, you know, I can see his innocence. I know he likes surprises, but I cannot remember giving. I might have, because I also like to give surprises, but, you know, since I've been out of the country for quite some time, and we've not been, so it's been a long time. But he likes surprises, and yes, I definitely plan to give him one. In coming months, or maybe on his birthday.
I see. Yeah. Okay. So, for question number 7, were you a part of any surprise plans? And you said yes.
Yes.
You guys gave a surprise to their dad.
Yes.
Okay.
And he and his brother and his cousin, they even prepared a song, you know, their dad. And then, yes, we were together, like, if that is the question.
Okay.
Yes, we were together.
He was a part of the surprise. All right. Plan.
Very recently.
Okay. Question number 8. What is your son most afraid of?
He's afraid of this scary movies.
So no horror films for him?
No. Definitely not. But not really horror. You know, there's this program where based on reality show, brutality.
Yes.
He doesn't like
That's
brutality.
Just like me, yeah. I'm too sensitive
yes.
to it. I overthink these true stories and... Yeah, it disturbs me a lot. So he's disturbed now.
Yes, and he avoids.
Okay, all right. So for that, I will take your answer as thriller or horror
Scary.
Films and stories.
Yeah.
Okay. Question number 9. What is one incident? Give me an incident. It could be funny or it could be embarrassing that you have of him. One incident related to him that was very embarrassing or funny.
I don't know whether he would find it funny, but... I thought this was funny. Yesterday, he couldn't sleep.
Yeah.
So he came into my room and slept with us, in fact, both the brothers. And the reason he told us that he missed me. So I thought that was very funny. Although we had a very cramped up long night.
I see.
Because these two boys usually sleep next room.
All right, okay. We'll take that as your answer. Question number 10, here's your last question. What is the one quality of your son of which you're so proud?
He's very humble, very modest, and I think he's sincere in what he does.
That's one quality that is very difficult for parents to instill, because I think it's something that is you're born with. I think it takes a lot out of a parent to teach modesty. Especially when you're fulfilling everything that kid is asking for, it is really hard to teach that kid to be modest about it. So you must be doing something good.
I try. In fact, me and my husband, we both try. Mm-hmm. Like, we are not really bothered about the nitty-gritty, the naughtiness that a child does, It's them,
Yeah.
But when it comes to certain thing like respect for food, throwing food, you know, and speaking back to elders.
Yes.
Like, of course, we encourage, as a modern parents, I think, educated. Yes, you need to make your point across.
Yes,
you have to stand for yourself. But again, you know, that value, you know, you don't really speak. You make your point across, but you don't really speak back. Like you say,
Guinea, yes.
So that I don't encourage, especially value for money.
Yeah.
They shouldn't, you know, just because your parents can afford certain things, you shouldn't take that thing for granted. Because, you know, ultimately, I always tell them when they throw food and when they refuse to eat, I always tell them that, of course, comparing is not good, but at some point, I think it's good. Kids in Africa, you know, they're starving. So those kind of small values we try to instill, and then hopefully they'll grow up to be a better human being.
And it just shows, if your son really is modest, it just shows that the little steps that you're taking towards making him realize what is important in life and not. I think it help. It is working. So kudos on that. Good for you. Now that you've answered all the 10 questions, we're going to invite your son over. Let me just tell you what we did with your mom. I've asked your mom 10 questions about you, and now it's your turn to answer. Tugush?
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
First of all, introduce yourself.
My name is Karma Kinga Dorji. I study in Tim Primary School. I'm going to class 6. I'm starting a hobby of collecting stamps, and that's all.
Okay. All right. So tell me, why have you started collecting stamps now?
I just like it. My brother, last time he said that my father had some stamps, and then I thought of that, why not just start a stamp collection and just start.
And what do you want to do it in the future once you have stamps from all the countries?
Maybe I'll sell them.
You think it'll fetch you a good price?
Yeah.
Like how much?
Don't know. It depends on the stamp.
Yeah, right? And how old the stamps would be by then, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. That's a good habit. You also... From stamps, you also learn the different names of the countries, towns, cities. Do you also know that you can make your own stamps?
Stamps? No, I didn't know.
You can make stamps with your own picture. You should explore that. Tugush?
Okay.
Maybe have your family picture there. All right, Karma. Your first question here. What is your favorite color?
Red.
Okay, why do you like red?
I like red because it's kind of like bloody and all, because it's like our inside out.
And you like that?
Yeah.
Really?
It looks cool.
Red is my favorite color. I just like it because it's bold, it's out there, right?
Yeah.
All right, question number 2. When was the last time you visited a park with your mom?
Maybe 2 years, 1 year back, because my mother went to Australia to study.
Okay, so it was a while back. Yeah. Where did you guys go?
Children's park, I think.
Children's park.
That's the only park.
Okay, Tim all park. Right. No, but there's the Botanical Garden Park, in there.
Oh.
Or you can just say just Botanical Garden, but any kind of park. It could be children's park, these gardens and other sanctuaries, if you have visited the Lumpery Park, in there? But okay, fine. Question number 3. What is your favorite book?
My favorite book is, I haven't actually read it, but I didn't actually finish, but I like Geronimo Stinson, The Kingdom of Fantasy.
Can you say the name of the book again?
Geronimo Stinson, The Kingdom of Fantasy.
The Kingdom of Fantasy. Okay, all right. Question number 4. What is your favorite school activity?
Football.
You like football? Why do you like football?
Football because my position is goalkeeper and I like to use my hands.
Goalie. All right, okay. What else do you like doing at school? What are other activities?
I like art and craft and music.
Okay, all right. If you have a toy, what's your favorite toy?
My favorite toy could be an action figure.
Okay, so give me an example here.
Example as in what kind?
Yeah, what kind of action figure?
Action figure as in a dragon action figure. You can move it anywhere, play around it, take out spots.
Okay, fix it. Dragon?
Dragon, D-R-A-G-O-N.
Okay, that name of the toy is dragon?
No, the action figure. Like, it can be any action figure. No.
Okay, all right. That's true. So, you like things that you can take apart and put it back?
Yeah, like a puzzle.
Okay, like a puzzle. Like the Transformers. Have you played with that? You can build it into the guy, or you can build it into the truck that it is.
No, I think
you'll like it, though. You like doing that, right? Like puzzle types. So, with this puzzle, you could either make the truck. You watch Transformers, right?
Yeah.
So you can make it into the Bumblebee car or the other trucks, that the ginormous trucks that they are. Or you could make it into the robot that they are. Remember?
Yeah.
Okay. Question number 6. During vacation, where do you prefer to go?
Bangkok.
Good. All right. Why do you like Bangkok?
Bangkok. I've never visited there, so I want to visit somewhere new.
Good for you. Question number 7. What's the biggest surprise you have ever been a part of? Have you been a part of a surprise?
Surprise, yeah, my father's birthday.
Oh, okay. Once. So how did you surprise? Tell me about it.
I kind of forgot it was a little time back.
Okay, it was a little while back, but I heard you were excited. Were you excited?
Yeah.
Did you scream?
Not that much.
Did Dad scream when he got the surprise?
Yeah, a little.
A little. How did he scream?
don't remember.
But I heard someone saying you made a song.
No, we took the lyrics out from the YouTube and sang.
Oh, okay. Can you sing it for me? What was the song? What was the name of the song?
It was One Direction song, Strong.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So now you're going to sing it for me? Because I don't know.
I don't remember the lyrics.
You can just go la 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 la, bluff bluff bluff. How does it start?
Your hands, my hands, tied up together.
Okay. So you can put in the tune and go. Go about.
Really?
Yeah, come on. We have had people walking the ramp here. We've had people dancing. We've had people singing. So you'll be one of the singers here.
Your hands, my hands, tied up like two ships, weightless. I don't know what
to write. No. More than anything, you need to have the confidence. Words the kachide. If you forget one, you can make another one.
I actually didn't know the meaning. I just sang it, so I don't actually know the definition.
But did your dad like
it? Yeah.
That's all that matters. Remember, you did something nice for your father, Imbe, and he liked it. That's the point, right?
Yeah.
The words really don't matter, at least right now. As you grow, you'll find out it does matter. Okay, thanks for singing. Let's go to our next question. What are you most afraid of?
I'm most afraid of spiders.
Okay.
They look creepy to me.
I know. I don't like anything that crawls. So spider is your fear?
Not that much, but I fear snakes.
Okay, other than animals, what do you fear? Maybe a situation, maybe anything?
I feel when I'm nervous in a situation.
Okay, but nervous, I think you have to be able to differentiate between being nervous and fearing. Do you fear coming on stage?
No.
Okay, so that's not fear then. So tell me, what are you afraid of? What do you like to be like, no, I'm not going to do that, or...
I'm afraid of my grandmother. She beats sometimes, so I don't dare to do something wrong in front of her.
Good for you, and good for your grandma. I love your grandma already. All right, okay. So you're most afraid of snakes and spiders?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll leave it at that. Question number 9. What is one experience that you had that was funny or embarrassing?
Funny or embarrassing?
Yeah.
Used to sleeping late and what? My mother didn't allow that yesterday, so I could not sleep and I went there.
What was the thing that you told mom when your mom asked, Kachube?
I missed her yesterday.
Okay, you missed her. All right, that's the answer? Yeah. Are you going to go with that?
Yeah.
Okay. What is one quality in you that your parents are most proud of?
I think because I'm not too boasty.
Okay, you don't boast too much about yourself, Inna?
Yeah, I don't boast. I just don't boast too much about myself.
Why though? But sometimes when you're good, you have to show it and tell people that you're good. Menga?
No, I don't like to show off too much.
Good for you. You know what? I was just kidding. But that's a very good habit you have. We are done with all the 10 questions. Should we take a look at the answers?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Mommy, are you ready?
Yes, please.
All right. If all his clothes could only be one color, what color would he choose?
Red.
Red.
When was the last time you and your son visited a park?
It's been a long time.
1 year back?
What is his favorite book?
The Kingdom of the Dragon here.
Kingdom of Fantasy?
What is his favorite school activity?
He likes science experiment.
Football.
What is his favorite toy?
Robot.
An action figure.
During vacation, where does your son prefer to go?
Bangkok.
Bangkok.
Surprises, or has he gotten any big surprises?
My husband's birthday.
My father's birthday.
What is your son most afraid of?
Scary movies.
Spiders.
Give me an incident, it could be funny or it could be embarrassing, that you have of him.
Yesterday he couldn't sleep.
Yeah.
So he came into my room
yesterday, so I could not sleep and I went there.
What is the one quality of your son of which you're so proud?
He's very humble, very modest.
I'm not too boasty.
We now have the scores, and your mom has scored 8 out of 10. Are you happy?
Kind of.
Are you an overachiever at school? Do you do well at school?
Not that much, but out of 10, I really do good. Out of 100, not that.
Okay, but if you convert that into 100, it's still 80, isn't it? So it's just equal to 80 in terms of hundreds.
Yeah, in subjects it's good, but in full, total's not.
All right, he's still not happy, but I think it's a great score because this was just 10 random questions out of so many things you know about him, and you still managed to do well. Now let's take a look at the two answers that you weren't able to answer correctly. That was favorite school activity. You've mentioned experimenting in science and games, and you particularly mentioned...
We can't do experiments in our school. Our sir does not let us do it.
Oh, okay. All right, so mom was completely off. But mom said you do like games, but she mentioned something called Foursquare, is that?
Foursquare, yeah.
Okay, Foursquare. But you've mentioned football.
Football?
But you said your answer was football, right? You like football, let them in.
Yeah.
So that is why we didn't give you any marks.
For school activity, I thought you meant like clubs.
Oh, no. No. I meant any school activity that you do at school. Second question that you weren't able to answer was, what is he most afraid of? Your mom said you don't like horror films.
Horror films? I love horror films.
Were you talking about your other son, Tshering?
But I just don't like to watch them, but I love them. Looks
what creepy. About true stories that are like the crime patrol?
Yeah, it sounds cool, but I just don't like it them, but I like them, see.
You don't watch them, but you like them?
Yeah.
But how is that possible?
Because I never watch them, that's why I don't
know. Why do you not watch them? I want to talk to you more about it. Yeah, India fight backs.
It's at night. I don't like it. I don't like to watch it at night.
Why?
And India Fights Back is not a horror film. It's like a series.
Yeah, but it's thriller, right? It's scary. I mean, it's scary to me. Maybe it's not scary to you. But you said you are afraid. You don't watch during the night, right?
Yeah, during the night I don't like to. It's scary at night.
How is it scary?
At the day it's not that scary. If I had a CD, I would watch everything in the day only.
Okay. Now tell me, why is it scary to you?
Don't know, because there's a lot of killing in there at night.
I know, it's gross, right? Yeah. But I think they are bringing this show with the objective to inform the people of the crimes that are going on. And they also make you aware of, okay, if you're in this situation, what should you do? So all this. But again, it's good to have an opinion, and I'm glad you are aware of what is coming in front of you and what you're trying to reject. That's very, very good. All right, 8 out of 10 is your score. I'm very proud of your mom. She scored well. Now let's go to our next segment, which is the commitment, okay? Anything you feel like you need to change.
Fighting with his brother, mm-hmm. I guess, you know, they don't even acknowledge that they're fighting. Mm-hmm. They're saying it's part and parcel of, you know, the brotherhood. So, but as a parent, you don't want your kids fighting for small things. So I just want to ask Karma to please not fight with your brother.
So, what's your answer to that?
No, I can't stop fighting.
Why?
Because he's too irritating to me sometimes, and I like to punch him in the face.
And you do?
No, then I don't, but I like to.
I would like to?
Yeah.
But then, if it's just going to stay to, I would like to, and if you're not going to punch him in the face, then you should tell your mom you wouldn't fight. Remember?
No, I can't say that, because if I did something wrong, then it would be completely breaking like the promise.
That is very true. But I think your mom has put a genuine request to you, saying maybe fight a little lesser.
Mostly he's the dog and I'm the kid. I'm always getting
Usually I actually can't punch him like that because he's younger to me. No, that's why.
If I was an enlightened being, what would I do? Something like that. So you question yourself and be a little tolerant.
Okay.
All right, you have promised your mom that you will try a little to stop the fighting. Is that true?
Yeah, 5%.
5%, that's still a progress. Yes. I will trust you on that. And next week, we're going to come to your home and see whether you're keeping up your promises or not.
Okay.
Let's go on to our next segment, which is the letter segment, which is with love.
Dear Karma, I love you and your brother Gilyang equally. I want to tell you that we'll always be friends, as I've always told you. We are friends first and I'm your mommy later. So you can share anything with me at any point in your life. I'll always be there for you. Be good. Lots of love, mommy.
What's your response? Do you have to say anything to her?
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, okay. Here's your letter to your mom. Please read it.
Dear Mom, I am so blessed to be your son. I am very lucky to be chosen by the Almighty to have such a nice and good mom. Not like all the other moms drinking wine and getting drunk. Thank you, Mom. Finish.
That letter deserves another reading. May I?
No.
No, okay. Can you just show the cover then?
Cover.
I think there's an interesting art there. It says, to my mom. All right. Now we're going to go to the favorite part, which is the last part of the show, which is the gift. I have this book by Tenzin. What's the name of the book?
His Majesty Jimmy Singe Wanchuk, the king who gave everything.
This is a book about the fourth king and the things he has done for us, the people and the country. Tugush, tell your friends about the book and about the story in the book. Tugush. I think that's more important. The other gift I have is from
Titan.
Titan, very good.
Thank you.
All right, do you know what's inside?
A watch.
So you know how to read time.
Yeah.
All right. Well, with this, Karma, we're done with the show. Thank you so much for coming to the show. I really appreciate it. I had so much fun. Did you?
Yes.
Good. And did you have fun, La?
Of course, La.
Good. As a parent, you should always express love and affection. A gentle cuddle, a little encouragement, appreciation, approval, or even a smile can go a long way to boost the child's confidence and well-being. Tell them you love them every day. Give lots of hugs and some kisses. Love them unconditionally. Don't force them to be who you think they should be in order to earn your love. Let them know that you will always love them no matter what. Come back next week, and if you'd like to be a part of this show, or if you have any suggestions or feedback, please email us at parenting@bbs.bt. Thank you and goodbye.